Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds Blind, now beginning the Peril on Gorgon DLC. Installed. Awesome. Now, from what I understand, we have to load before the point of no return, and then travel anywhere, and the quest will begin. So this is our current version, and my save version, but everything should work fine. The only thing is, they've basically reset to default my key bindings or otherwise messed them up. See, I have... This is crouch. And now I'm pressing another key, crouch. One should be sprint. So... I am going to quickly change this around. And I'll be right back. Okay, that was annoying. It looked like it was saving all my key bindings, but it wasn't actually doing that. It would display them just fine. Like here, it would show up exactly how I want it to be, but that button would not work. It was like a hidden... It had a hidden setting that did not reflect what was displayed. So I had to reset everything to default and then do everything again. Which was annoying. I know some people... Well, some people had problems because the Epic Games Store released the DLC early, along with an update, as it's supposed to happen, but then it didn't work. Or something like that, or I think it worked fine for people, but then they ended up taking the DLC down and, messing up people's saves. Glad it didn't happen to me, but I feel bad for anyone who might have gone through that. Hopefully everything will be just fine now, knocking on wood. So, yeah. For anyone interested in my character. Level 30, I have these stats and everything like this. This is where I save, well, this is where I ended up with the game. I think this is the level cap. But this is back, and I have these skills. Really good in persuade, pretty good in line, that's a good intimidate. Got some medical engineering, just mostly reminding myself right now. Perks. Stuff for anyone interested. That's what I have. And I've been using, I've been kind of switching back and forth, or I was switching back and forth, but my favorites are Porvarty and Vicar Max. Although Nyoka's pretty close third favorite. I have stuff. Well, this is Nyoka's stuff, anyway. Here's my stuff. I have plenty of everything. What do I tend to use? Finn's Force. Energy Weapon. Assault Rifle Ultra. Heavy Machine Gun 2. Mind Control Ray, which I haven't used much of, or any of, actually. And this is, the Chimera from Celestial Liqueur. Defensive Helmet. I have some stuff. I have some more stuff. And there's even more stuff. Quests. Quest items. Alright, anyway. We have to go anywhere, so let's go anywhere. Groundbreaker. Excited.
Captain? I'm receiving an urgent docking request from another vessel.
Greetings from the Halcyon Parcel Service. Delivery is guaranteed within standard margins of certainty. I've got a special delivery for Alex Hawthorne of the Unreliable. With your permission, I'll see it transferred to your ship.
Right, so this is the message we're looking for, and other than that, I'm going into this completely blind. I know we end up going to this place called Gorgon, which is a planet, I think? Or maybe an asteroid? I'm not sure. And Peril goes on there. I've heard varying things that the DLC's not that good. I've heard that it's pretty damn good. Just no spoilers, please, guys, on it, because yeah, at least when you watch this episode, I'll still be in the middle of it. I doubt I'm going to finish it all in one night. Anyway, what is it?
It's a parcel, ma'am.
No, I mean, what's the parcel?
A parcel is a shipment wrapped and prepared for delivery, ma'am.
Oh, you're going to get it. I'm asking you what's inside this parcel.
Opening a customer's parcel is strictly against regulations. HPS's no peeking policy guarantees that your deliveries remain confidential and HPS remains free of any liability.
No peeking policy? What if I don't want it?
I am contractually obligated to deliver my cargo to the captain of the Unreliable under pain of fines, imprisonment, and censure by my superiors.
They would imprison him. Then why did you ask for my permission?
That's the HPS difference for you. Service with civility. Stand by, Captain Hawthorne. An HPS certified distribution technician has deposited the parcel into your cargo hold in accordance with hazardous waste disposal procedures.
Waste disposal procedures? They did what?
They dispensed 3 complimentary spritzes of Anti-Cleo's Citrus Squirt Air Freshener. That's the HPS touch for you, Captain Hawthorne. On behalf of HPS, I'd like to remind you that HPS is not responsible for any damage, defacement, or unseemliness to your parcel. Thank you for your patience, and please remember HPS for all of your future parcel-related needs.
Make a rude hand gesture and then cut the transmission. It doesn't make a difference in any case. So we have a parcel. What's this say? The ones who walk away from Gorgon. The Halcyon Parcel Service delivered a package for Alex Hawthorne. Since Hawthorne is out of the picture, the package is yours by law. Hawthorne's package is in the Unreliable's cargo hold. Indeed it is. Oh, it slowly opens. What the hell is that? That's a chopped off arm holding something.
Hawthorne, if you're getting this, something's happened to me.
Montoya!
Got mixed up in some shady business on Gorgon. Should have known better. But I landed on something big. And now this job's an itch I can't stop scratching.
I love the poster! It's like a Dungeons & Dragons
There's
module.
There's a research compound left to the Sprats. I think I'm close to figuring out why. But something dangerous is closer to me. Got the job through one Minnie Ambrose. Top runner who just came into some money was offering a hefty bid card for qualified help. Trust me. Her money's good. Talk to Minnie. Take the job. If I ain't gonna live to see the payday, might as well be you. Consider us even, old pal.
Thanks.
Well, that fellow certainly seemed trustworthy.
I've gotten jobs from some unusual sources, but this is a first. Congratulations, Captain.
I don't mean to sound prim, Captain, but...
Prim.
There's gotta be a better way to ask someone to do you a favor.
Don't think I had a choice.
I just want to say... We gotta take this job. This is the closest I ever been to starring in a serial drama. Only thing we're missing is a couple cameras and a soundtrack.
Typical Felix.
At least this won't be boring.
Ada, what the hell is going on?
Lucky Montoya owed Captain Hawthorne a considerable debt. I believe this is what humans refer to as payback, Captain. The message contains landing coordinates for a small asteroid in the Charybdis cluster. It was recently registered to a Wilhelmina Ambrose.
Who was this guy, Anna?
He was an old friend of Alex Hawthorne's.
I get that.
Lucky Montoya had a statistically significant tendency to encounter situations of extreme danger.
Well, yeah. I doubt this guy lost his arm filling out paperwork.
He was also the fourth best paid freelancer in the system.
Only the fourth?
There are several hundred freelancers operating in Halcyon. Considering the numbers, Mr. Montoya ranked among the top percentile. This had less correlation with his measured aptitudes, which rank at or below average, than with a pattern of fortunate circumstances.
I guess I should be impressed. Any chance he's alive?
Based on the condition of the limb, I calculate a 92.7% chance that Mr. Montoya expired from his injuries.
So you're saying there's a chance? A 7.3% chance?
There's what humans colloquially call a sprat's chance in a mantisaur's den. That is a very low chance, Captain. I have transferred the coordinates for Ambrose Manor to your navigation terminal. We can travel there when you are ready.
Hold up.
Something on your mind?
Let's talk about the Gorgon job.
If there's one thing you could say about Lucky Montoya, he was always at the center of a story. Guess this is fitting.
You knew him?
Sure. Like Ada said, he was a big name among freelancers. I met him at Lost Hope once. He was buying rounds for everyone and telling a story about one of his jobs. Pretty sure half of it was made up.
Why do you say that?
You ever get the feeling someone's just trying too hard? I'm gonna ignore that bit of subtext, Captain. There was just something about Montoya I couldn't quite trust. He was always at the center of a room, and he slapped a lot of backs to stay there.
I didn't mean her by saying uh-huh, but it seems... So you think so? So?
I'm trying to say that if he screwed this job up, that's on him. I still like our odds. He may have had a rep, but you're more capable than he ever was.
Well, that's nice of you to say.
Hey, don't get used to it. What's on your mind?
Any idea what happened to Lucky?
From his arm? The decay makes it hard to tell. Could be a lot of things. Torn off by something with big teeth, torn off by something with big claws, torn off by someone with a moderately sharp blade. Or maybe he just got too close to heavy machinery.
Alright, thanks.
Sure. Something on your mind?
Well, I gotta ask everybody.
Yes, you caught me ruminating again. Guilty as charged. What's occupying your thoughts?
Max, what's your take on the whole Gorgon business?
Perhaps it's just my judicious nature, but I think we should be careful if we're following up on this lucky fellow's message.
Why do you say that?
I've always felt caution as the best approach when one has delivered a message attached to a severed limb.
Noted. But what do you think of what he was saying?
He sounded lost. Perhaps slightly untethered from reality. A feeling I know all too well.
Yeah.
It doesn't strike me as a setup, but I still advise caution.
So you think we should look into it?
Why not? It is what we do, isn't it?
All right, Max. Thanks.
Hey, Cap.
Hi, Naoka. Let's talk about this Gorgon job.
Sure.
How you feeling about it?
Right now, I'm feeling like a canid following a trail of treats. Like I'm being misled at best. At worst, walking into a trap. Keep those eyes open, Captain.
Well, she doesn't have as much to say.
Hey, Cap.
Battery levels are fully charged.
Good work, Sam.
Thank you, customer. This area is utterly filthy.
Well, then back to work.
Captain?
So, Parvati walked off, and I gotta ask her. Well, that's Felix. I think she's the only one I haven't asked.
Hawthorne, if you're getting this, something's happened to me. Got mixed up in some shady business on Gorgon. Should have known better. And now this job's an itch I can't stop scratching. There's a whole research compound left to the Sprats. I think I'm close to figuring out why, but something dangerous is closer to me. Got the job through one Minnie Ambrose, top runner who just came in.
Oh. We'll be ready to hear it at once. I thought I could listen to it while looking through here. They should add messages to this sometimes. I mean, maybe as we progress through the story.
If you're getting this, something's happened to me. Got mixed up and some...
It restarted, okay.
The ship used to be much quieter.
Sorry, I didn't mean to keep playing that message.
Something busted, Captain?
What are your thoughts on Gorgon?
It's a shame about what happened to that lucky fella. Maybe finishing what he started will help put his spirit to rest.
You've poked around the Unreliable. Ever find any record of Lucky Montoya?
Not a word. And I've been sticking my nose in every one of our stately ladies' crannies, stem to stern.
That's interesting.
Oh, law. That sounds untoward, don't it? that ain't what I meant. Point is, Captain, Mr. Hawthorne left all kinds of scribblings behind panels and under consoles, but ain't a lick of it mentioned Mr. Lucky. So whatever they got up to in the past must have been really extra secret. And lots of fun.
Huh. Kind of curious what scribbles she finds behind panels and stuff. How are you feeling about this job right now?
It sure is lonely out here on the edge of the colony. Anything could happen. And ain't no one gonna come to help us. Alrighty. You change your mind, you just holler.
You know, whoever wired this ship up had no idea what they were doing.
You want to ask about anything in particular, Captain?
I don't get a chance to say, let me know if you find anything. I guess she will. Alright. Alright, so... A cryptic phonograph left by Lucky Montoya mentioned a high-stakes job and a wealthy client. Minnie Ambrose. The job was dangerous enough to cost Lucky his arm and possibly his life. Ambrose Manor is located on a remote asteroid in the Charybdis Cluster. Alright, so... This is otherwise my character, as you would have known her right before she headed to... Tartarus. Which is here. For the end game. So this is like right before that. A remote asteroid, home to marauders, smugglers, and an abandoned Spacer's Choice facility. Alright. This be the place. Ambrose Manor. Ambrose Manor, here we come. Exciting. I wonder where the actual manor is, if it's that, or the, over there. Well, I'll take these two. Parvati and Max. New loading screen on Gorgon. It's always Adrena time, made with real xenocyte waste. Yummy.
Welcome to Ambrose Manor. We were not expecting company. Please follow. Do not stray from the path.
Well, we're not known for going where we're told, but we'll see what we can do.
Exactly. I want to look around.
Oh no! We should check to see he's all right.
I've never seen a more effective argument against blindly following a preordained plan.
All right. We will go down there shortly and see if there's anything This place looks a little creepy. I hear... Is he alright? He looks like he's still functioning. Not that he can get up, though. No, there's nothing around here. Alright. Alright, ready, guys? Is this the manor? Huh, unknown. Well, the quest... Oh, so she's over here. Then what is this?
Got it. Inside voices.
Adreno. Okay. It's fun going through this again. Pneumatic piston. Gonna be a little rusty, guys, so don't mind me. Kitchen key card. Groundskeeper's Journal, Volume 1. Daily routine, sweep the Tranquility Garden for Mrs. Olivia. Oil the fist for Mr. Harvey. Repeat. When they hired me on as groundskeeper, I assumed there'd be grounds to keep. I'm not even allowed inside the manor. Everyone told me the Ambrose family keeps to themselves, but they're a bunch of hermits. Save for the little one. Guess I ought to find a hobby. Mr. Harvey dropped his keycard in the pond. I'll hold on to it, in case he ever comes looking. But I won't go near the house. Wouldn't want to get between Mrs. Olivia and her research. So this is just a groundkeeper's, like, shack or something? That's barred. A shovel and a pickaxe. Really just take that stuff to sell, if I can. Well, I guess we're not getting in there yet. Oh, I missed that one.
Clinging, clinging, canned responses. How clumsy of this unit. These things happen. Oh, calamity.
Oh, calamity. Well, things start opening fire on us. Well, that's interesting. I'm gonna go look. It's like a rock garden. Tranquility garden. Certainly is interesting. I like it. But there's nothing to do here. Except hang out and try to become tranquil.
Those big empty windows. Feels like the building's watching me.
Oh, I'm getting
goosebumps. What's that? People go to extraordinary lengths to define themselves, won't they? This is just a facade to hide behind.
Wait, that's on a track. Like this fish moving through the... It's a track, though. Saltuna Pond. In quotes. Really? What if I stand in the way of the oncoming fish car thing? Oh. That tickled. Well, it's certainly different. Out of the way goodies. Call a spade a spade. So, and there's another one over here. Pays to look around. Okay. Ambrose Manor. I guess I'll put this away. Doesn't seem to be anything out here that would cause us harm. If there is, I can just take the gun out quickly. Alright, nothing out here on the terrace or whatever this might be. Hello? Mrs. Ambrose? I was gonna say Montrose. I mean, ooh, stand by, guys. Hey, that was a sneeze.
So empty. Oh, Captain, something here don't feel right.
This place has the distinct feeling of a crypt.
Hmm. Food service mechanical and a janitor. Yeah, this place looks pretty abandoned. There's a charging station for the robots or androids. At least the fine china is undisturbed. Unlock with kitchen keycard. We have that. Let's check this. Domestic automechanical routines. Hope you guys can see this. It's a little dim. Main menu. Oh, wait. Oh. Click here. Logs. Recent activity. Domestic automechanical routines. Event ID number 37727. User W. Ambrose attempted to log into system. Final attempt failed. Locking terminal for 5 days. And then we go descending event IDs. User W. Ambrose attempted to log into system. 1 try remaining. 2 tries remaining. Routine maintenance logs omitted. User O. Ambrose activated dinner time protocol. Meal was woolly loaf. User H. Ambrose activated dinner time protocol. Meal was tripical salad. O. Ambrose meal was borst roast. Corruption detected in earlier logs omitting. Corrupted entries. Pantry list. Pantry stock. Last automated check was error. Null date to fine. Salt tuna fillets. Stock is spoiled. Please replenish. Same for woolly cow, steak, and mock apples. Borst and beans. 13 cans remaining. Mock apple shake. 9 bottles remaining. Can't actually change the routines of the thing. Oh. Death certificate of Olivia Ambrose. To Miss Wilhelmina Ambrose. This certificate affirms that you are the sole inheritor of the Ambrose estate, having drafted, filed, indexed, stamped, and unstamped the necessary forms to declare your mother legally deceased. Congratulations and condolences. Now that's a hell of a thing to say. Congratulations and condolences. This has been a long time coming. Even without access to your full inheritance, you have grown the Ambrose fortunes beyond this firm's wildest dreams. Bailey Clark, estate manager. Wow. So Olivia Ambrose dead. Oh, I picked that up.
Yeah, huh?
Any thoughts?
You want to ask about anything in particular, Captain?
How are you feeling about the job right now?
It sure is lonely out here on the edge of the colony.
All right. And okay. Are you trying to go through the kitchen? There's another one there. I'm trying to get out of your way. You're a good dance partner. Alright. I'm about ready to ignore you.
As always, I am at your disposal. What's occupying your thoughts?
What's your take on all this?
Perhaps it's just my judicious nature, but I think we should be careful if we're following up on this. I've always felt caution as the best approach when one has delivered a message attached to a severed limb.
Do you think it's a setup?
He sounded lost, perhaps slightly untethered from reality.
Yeah.
A feeling I know all too well. It doesn't strike me as a setup, but I still advise caution.
If it is a setup, whoever's behind it will regret it.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
So I'm really torn as to whether to go upstairs for the objective. She's up there somewhere. Not too far away. Or should we just go right into the kitchen? Maybe we're going to get a chance to go in the kitchen afterwards. Let's check it out.